know, right? We have been okay, let me again do this one. Okay, thanks for joining. As we all know that the session is currently on what after intermediate, and many people, you know, have chosen engineering as a subject. So this session would be specifically for those who are getting into the engineering as a career. So before we get into the detailed session, let me introduce myself. I am Syed Munawar. I did my, you know, BE from Mufa Khamja College in back in 2004, and ME from BITS Pilani. That's my course on behalf of my company. I am currently working as a technical leader looking at the software for plant controls engineering in a MNC here in Hyderabad. And also I am a general secretary for Career Guidance Council. So this is a small introduction about myself. And as you all know, that Career Guidance Council, CGC, we talks about, is a non-profit organization we have formed back in 2008 with the aim to help people like you choose their right career, and, you know, people, those who are looking for jobs, so that we can update their skills and fill the gaps, get them on the employment. So Sarath, there are many activities that we do under CGC. One of them is the career guidance, wherein which we visit schools on every Saturday or on any weekday also sometimes, and help the students in choosing their right career, I would say. And also, you know, supports the job fairs for those who are unemployed and those who are looking for jobs, and drive some sort of programs that would help them upgrade their employability skills. And also go to graduate colleges, engineering colleges, conduct sessions on various things and all. So this is a little bit about the CGC. And I request all of you to, you know, get into the CGC website, that is careerguidancecouncil.org, and look there and try to understand what we do. If I know that one after some days or few days, you would be also a working professional. So CGC is one of the good platform where, you know, as a professional, as a working professional, we can give back to the society. Our country needs people like us who can, you know, help the other people who are not having jobs. So this is a platform we have created, and so far we have have helped many thousands of people across the country, not just in Hyderabad, in getting a right job. So much to talk about CGC, but this is little bit of about this one. And also I request those who are working professional, join us as volunteers, and those who are job seekers, try to leverage the potential of CGC and get to the job. Any help that you need, you can, you know, get in touch it with the Abdul Wahid, who is having the same number being listed on the at the end of the slide. You can see the same. Okay, so this topic is very serious and very close to my heart. Why I have chosen this, because this is a place where, you know, many people get confused. We understand that people were very confused when they choose the what is MPC, BIPC, CEC after their 10th class or SSC. But I mean, as they get into the intermediate, now they have decided that what they are the next step. So the people who have taken MPC, definitely majority of them have a plan to go into engineering, while the BIPC and the rest of the subjects have their own specialization. So this is about the MPC that we are going to. So this is the right time that we need to think of which branch we have to choose. So career choices are life choices, for sure. Take them seriously and do it right. So my presentation today is not that which engineering is best, which engineering is great, but we'll talk about what the market demands, because there is no point in learning something which is not benefiting you in getting a job or, you know, building your career. So this is basically, we'll go through the what is going to be the, you know, the industry demands in the coming 5 to 10 years or 20 years. And then you can decide by yourself which engineering that you want to do. Okay. And we'll help you also at the end, before the end of the session, as by taking some Q&A as if you have any specific questions. So let me go ahead. Okay. So let's start with the skills required for an engineer. So before we decide what branch we need to get into, let's decide what undergraduate engineers need actually. So as we all know that the world is getting into continuous evolution of digital transformation, and this digital transformation need new skills. So like back in 2000, when I was getting into engineering, I did not know that which engineering is best or what, but only whatever branch I got into engineering, I got selected in that one. So I get into civil engineering initially. Then after one month of time, you know, there was some sliding happens, and the college administration people called me and said, there is one opening in instrumentation engineering. Are you able, do you want to get into that one from civil? I happily said, yes, I can get into. Give me a couple of minutes, just I have to reduce some noise around me. Sorry guys, it is Sunday, so I am at home with all my kids and family. We have a joint family, sorry that. Okay, so this is a digital transformation that is going on across the years and across the industries. And as I told you just now about my getting into this one. So at that time, we did not know much about the field that we are getting into, but we took whatever comes in front of us. But that should not be the case today, because we need to be very serious in choosing our career. What is going to be in demand in the coming year, that is more important for us. So it's a world of digital transformation, and we require new skills. Just remember this one. It's a world of digital transformation. Everything is getting digital, not just because of pandemic and all. Even this transformation is happening well before that, but we need to understand what skills that this transformation requires in the coming years. So we need to develop new skills. So what are those new skills, and how do we adapt that new skills in our engineering? Whatever we are going to choose is to be decided now. So digital skills will be required for every career field. So if someone says I am into civil engineering, and why should I, what digital skills I need? If someone just want to remain a site engineer, if someone want to do some manual work and be a civil engineer, their job is not going to be there in few years, because that is going to be transformed, or, you know, getting into the hands of robots, at least some of the jobs. That requires, so it doesn't mean that there will no jobs. There is a replacement of job. There is no, you know, kind of cutting of jobs in this digital transformation, but definitely there will be a portion of jobs which will not be there for sure. So digital skills will be required for every career field as an increasing percentage of. I request all the people to, you know, hide their camera, or Vahid, you can remove them if they are not following this one. Let them mute their video camera also. Okay, so digital skills will be required for every career field as an increasing percentage of the world GDP is represented by the digital economy. So as we know, digital transformation requires new skills, and every skills is there in the every career field. So this is very important in terms of this one. Vahid, you there in the call?
Yes.
Why can't you remove the one who is not muting their video? Is it not possible?
No, it is possible. I'm doing it right now.
Let's be active and do that one. Don't wait for me to tell you. Okay, fine. So guys, remember this slide, very important. It is an era of digital transformation. We require new skills. And every engineering you are going to choose requires some sort of digital skills. What are those? We'll learn in the next slides. Okay, I think I have moved. Okay, so we often heard this word innovation as if something which, you know, someone came and, you know, do a new thing, and many people claps and all, right? So in that, that is not the definition of innovation. Innovation is a word that we hear often. It is often being mistaken. So innovation is not always about creating or inventing. It's new, creating or inventing any new thing. It's about using the latest technology to improve the current ways. So this is the definition of innovation. So we might be thinking, somebody has innovated something and we don't have that mind or creativity in ourselves to do this innovation. But innovation is something not to create anything new. It is to use the technology and make it that particular thing work or perform in a different way. That is called innovation. So let's say something is getting done today in 40 hours and making the same work in 10 hours using the technology, that is also called innovation. So every field that we are going to talk about, any engineering that you choose, is all about innovation today, because every CEO of the company, every owner of the company, anyone want to reduce the cost of the operations and earn more money so that they can be a digital economy player in the whole digital market. So innovation is a very big word, as you can say. So what derives innovation is this: idea, process, development, inspiration, creativity, vision, growth. And everyone, as a human, we have all this potential within us. It is just that we need to explore that in the right way at the right time. So what skills that we need? What skills will undergraduate engineers need now? So these are also very important points. I think you should be noted down or take a snap of this one. The most important aspect of technology is human capital. That means anything that is required today to do the job, it means we as people work in a company. But there are technologies, factors. For example, usually people of traveling to 5 years or 10 years before, we did not thought of going into marriages or parties in cars. We used to have auto only, and that too we have to go out of the home and hire an auto and come back again and get into this kind of thing. Today we are doing that on the phone and we are ordering Ola or Uber, whatever it is. So many such technologies are disrupting many sectors. So when I'm taking sectors, it can be agriculture, energy, manufacturing, whatever you name it, that is coming is disrupting people. Today we don't see much people digital also. So many things have come up. So this is a transformation happening. So these technologies are driving the fourth industrial revolution. Revolution will come. But understand, as the technology, so getting the technologies of this autonomous robotics, IoT, internet, connecting two systems of system integration, cyber security. These are the few these are the main drivers. So whenever they try to influence us, whenever something comes, disrupted many of these sectors. System integration, many people previously used to work on the electrical type of things in the thing. As we get into the more into the electronics, we are getting that thing, things getting done in a very small way, in a very fast way, I would say. So like we know that the computer, today we have a laptop and today we have a tablet or a smartphone, which is itself is a computer. You can see that how the things are getting transformed in this digital era. So any technology that is getting into its advanced stage is disrupting these sectors. Any sector, you name it. These are just mentioned few, but anything advancement in this technology will disrupt these sectors. So what it requires, the skills required by this new economy are highly transferable and changeable. It's not needed in every. That means if you 2021, when you passed out in 2026 or 27, whatever it is, there will be different technologies in front of you. But that doesn't mean that you will be learning that one. But today, what is available, you need to learn so that you can update yourself on a regular basis. That's what everyone needs to learn continually. So see this is very dangerous. And I put it in red because to show the importance of this one, reskilling is not needed every 2.5 to 3 years. So those who are thinking doing engineering, getting the job is the only thing, they should not take engineering now. this is not the right time to take engineering. If they are a person who just want to work like a they don't want to upgrade themselves, they want to remain a person of doing the same thing for the coming 35 years, engineering is not a field for them. They'll be kicked out at some point of time, and they are no more in demand in the market. So they have to learn continuously the new skills, and it has to be done every 2.5 to 5 years. This is very important. The current undergraduates who are into engineering now, who are getting to engineering, it means that getting a diploma certificate is not the end anymore. So doing engineering is just not going to end anymore. Continued learning and development are the key. Employers don't assess what a candidate knows anymore, but how fast they can learn. So the employers need people who can learn quickly and adapt to the current challenges. They don't want people of, you know, gold medalist or something who have done wonders in their academics, but they don't want to change themselves, and they want a job based on their academics. That is going to happen now. So these are the things which is very important that we need to keep in mind while we are choosing our engineering branch now. Next, you can put the questions in the chat window. We can take a letter, or you can, you know, just hold up. We can give you a chance to ask questions. So Industry 4.0, we just talked about in the previous slides about Industry 4.0. So Industry 4.0 is all about industrial transformation using new digital technology. So whatever technology is coming, the transforming, you can see that originally the any manufacturing plant, any cement plant, any power plant, any oil and gas refineries, anything that you see for 20 years or like a black kind black very plant kind of thing, but it's being lighted technology. They are increase money. What is 4.0? IoT makes to analyze data across machines and business systems, enabling faster, more flexible. So this is a definition of 4.0. IoT is nothing but Industry 4.0. It is Industrial Internet of Things. It's nothing but Industry 4.0. Sectors across the industries. So, and the other thing, enterprises use the latest IoT, edge, cloud computing, big data, artificial sensors, autonomous, cobots. Cobot is something which, but cobots are one along with the human. Insight into real. So basically, if you see, if you understand this, what is going to be in Industry 4.0 in the coming days, I request all of you to throw this link. There are some series of 8 to 10 lectures, watch these lectures and understand that how, whether it is mechanical engineering, electrical, how it is getting integrated in every field. There is no such engineering now, like, you know, I'm a civil engineer. If something happens to my computer, I will wait for the computer technician to come and, you know, repair my system. That is not going to happen anymore, because that civil engineer has to know how to troubleshoot the computer or the laptop that he's carrying or working on. And if there is anything to be written, like, because the companies are demanding such kind of skills from a person who is literate in the sense that degree in the respect to engineering, but also they want some flavors or, you know, some skills related to these technologies, artificial, whatever it is and all. So this slide is basically to tell you about how the transformation is getting happen. So there are some series of lectures. I request everyone who are getting into engineering, who are into engineering, to please go through these lectures and understand and plan this one. Next, the talent shortage issue. It's not that there are no jobs in the market. There are jobs in the market, but there is no talent that the company is looking for. So we have thousands and lakhs of millions of people. The company is also having the same number of jobs, might be right talent that they are looking for. So approximately 64% of the CEOs believe technology will disrupt how they do business. Then the skill gap will be what institutions do to address quality in a rapid change development in online education. Now, however, one of the big challenges for engineering and scientific schools, colleges, is the difficulty in providing students a real hands-on experience and approach to practical learning. We all know that engineering colleges apart from IITs or NITs or some big institutes, the normal engineering colleges, the fourth level of engineering colleges, are just like any other, you know, colleges we have with some practical labs. Much of being motivated to be able to adopt there. So only way to solve this challenge is to able to based on engineering. Used to go away, used to, you know, avoid doing practicals lab because we think that whatever it comes in after our engineering, it is going to be a job. Why we should spend more time in doing these practicals? But the current market demands this one, right? So the only way to solve the challenges of talent shortage between the companies and the colleges, universities, is to able to provide a full interactive lab experience based on real hardware remotely, whatever it is. But the question, real question for you guys who are here in the call, you wait for colleges to provide this practical experience. Let's say you get into some engineering college and you find that there is no proper laboratories they have, there is no proper faculties they have. What do you do? You just sit and wait for them to ruin your life or wait till the end of your engineering and then later you cry that your college was not good. That's not going to be happen now because there are so many avenues available to you. Online, you have so many laboratories. Online, there are so many resources available to do the practical trainings. And there are so much of online resources in the sense like many online, like Udemy provides some sort of free courses, Coursera provides some free courses. So there are many online tutorials who provide free courses. So at this point of time, start exploring those, you know, available tools in the sense, avoid wasting time on the social media, put that same efforts on your learning so that you will be competitive in the job market. Otherwise, this will be very difficult for you. Now, coming to the main thing of our session, what are the main skills required by the future job market? While repetitive tasks will mostly likely not be needed anymore as robots can take those on, there are certain core technical skills that will be required no matter the field of expertise. Whether you are a civil engineer, whether you are a mechanical engineer, whether you are electrical, instrumentation, communication, whatever engineer you are, you require these technical skills that come into a engineer and, you know, doing something over the plate, even a plant skills, which every company demands it now. So whether it is an in-house job, working on a laptop, whether it is a job that you go to any plant or site and doing working, everywhere you require a core skills of this one in order to grow in your career. So what are those core technical skills? Big data, data analysis, software development, app and web development, artificial intelligence and machine learning, user experience, robotics, process automation, database and system administration, IoT. So these are the core skills that you might thinking, engineering, I don't think so. We should not be getting into that kind of mindset that this has from the first year of our engineering. Get starting from one or two things from this one and build and mention in your resume so that people takes you as the preferable candidate for the job instead of moving around so many companies and all. So try to build these core skills in your career and don't wait for the engineering to complete and then you start day one of your engineering, first year of your engineering, that you need to build these core skills. You have 4 years in your hands to build these skills and getting some sort of hands-on so that you know if you are a civil engineer where my big data applies. Big companies who are doing big construction, they are dependent on data and they need civil engineers decision for do this data with me of the last 25 years. With this data, and these are the tools, person with BCom degree, a person with a BSA degree, any other engineer other than civil engineer, if he asks them to do this analysis, he will not be able to do. The reason is his expertise is not civil, but he is good in data analysis or big data. But the company demands a civil engineer should know the data analysis or big data so that he know the terms and main skills required for the job market. You should be knowing this one. Technical skills. So what else? You might be a strong, you know, in some sort of technical skills, but that is all not you need. Technical knowledge will simply not be enough. There is a set of human specific skills that are applicable to any scientific or industrial job. And that will be their underlying skill needed for every function together with technology. Such skills are analytical thinking and innovation. You just need not be, you know, an expert. You also require human skill to grow. Say you are a 98%, you are not able to. So let's say you are taking. Well, what is the use of that knowledge if you have, and if you're not able to spread or, you know, educate someone, right? So you require coaching skills, you require teaching skills, you should be a good team player, some sort of. So this, the headline you hear, technical skills will not be on, be all you need. You require technical skills, but you also require the human specific skills that are applicable to scientific job. So analytical thinking and innovation, active learning, creativity, originality, initiative, critical thinking and analysis, complex problem, leadership and social influence, emotional intelligence, reasoning and ideation, people, culture, organizational development, innovation, management. So what I'm trying to say here is, these are the skills that as a human being we should have apart from technical skills in order to sustain in the market. If you have just engineering degree and you don't have these skills, better not to look for a job also. In a world where everything could potentially be automated, using robot jobs of the human. There are some skills which robots cannot understand, and these are these skills robot cannot understand, right? So if we have these skills along with the technical, we can compete with robots. And if you have only technical skills with you, you cannot compete with robots. Technical skills is this, robots also, and that's what the company needs. In a world where automated, unique, which cannot will be valuable and a key differentiator in talent search. So company will look for this and also human skills in order to choose you. Otherwise, they are happy with the robots. Okay. So the next is how to do career planning. For the possibilities, things out, narrow choices. Think choices so that you conclusion. Make choices, set goals, develop plan and address the barriers. Development in good. I are from advanced or mains. NIT is also same. Universities, colleges. If you have written a state level competitive exam for getting into engineering, you will get only into colleges. If you do engineering from this, you have a job and getting into a good company. The current also taught only in the first two kind of institutes are hardly being so advanced to get to the pace with which the industries are moving. Engineering branches, these are the engineering branches everyone knows. I don't want to name it, but I want to talk about some specific aeronautical fourth level colleges. These fourth level college aeronautical which is not a engineering to do from this college. Institutes for this one, then you can go for it. Don't choose aeronautical engineering from any fourth level colleges or from any universities. Go for only specific institutes where the aeronautical engineering is being taught and whose campus placement are good so far. So we have civil engineering, triple E, IT, automobile production, metallurgical, textile, marine, agriculture, electronics, chemical, petroleum, biotechnology, mining, biomedical. So there are many, but I have listed only few. There is one confusion between computer science engineering and IT. Don't worry, take it once and go ahead. There is one more confusion between computer science and big data analytics. Something is coming up. It is better to get into the general degree rather than getting into the specific degree, because always the general degrees are being preferred over the specific one, because even if it is a computer science with and all, they are going to teach you only for one or two semester additional special subjects, but that should not be making you specific to only that particular general degree. What should be your strategy after your engineering? Let's do this one. You should be doing in order to build this. Build those skills. Make sure that you don't have any backlog in your engineering, because people don't need any player which is zero in their career. In Indian 4 to 5 player, they are always there. Every country they are, any they are there. Anyone who is not performing, removed, and they have other people have been taken. So be consistent in your percentage and have a good percentage. Let's say about 65 or 70. Above 70 is a very nice one. And don't have any backlog, because that will create that will make you being not getting selected in many of the companies also, because they don't want people who have a backlogs in their career. Member of professional bodies. There are many professional bodies through which you will get magazines and some sort of additional information. Similar for civil engineering, mechanics. That is the first step. Is checking you. Computers. There was a time. Now we used to. I see hundreds of resume. They mention as any engineering graduate. They mention computer skills as MS Office. Today the demand is even a 10th class student should have MS Office skills, so that he can able to submit the assignments, soft copy. Faculties. So MS Office is now that a 10th class student should be okay. So computer skills here means the other one, which language skills, spoken English as well, paper presentation in technical fest. There are many engineering colleges organize technical festivals. Definitely you'll get a chance to present papers there. Present a paper so that you learn something. Present paper on like how your engineering is getting affected because of some technology. That way you can learn respective fields. Technical quiz, get into the technical quiz, try to win prizes. Will definitely help. There will be many competition today are organizing years and trying to modelize it and getting into the some good ideas that we can do. So these are something that we need to get into. Soft skills, we all know that what comes under this one. Internships. Don't wait for your final year to come so that you can start the internships. From day in your family, anyone is working, on some day, so that you get the feeling of how the company is inside, how they work, and how it look like. That will be helpful and give you some good idea of it. So you can make industrial visit. Don't wait for college to organize your industrial visit. You can do by yourself also. Utilize forums to meet experts. CGC is one of the forum where you can meet those people who are working in industries. Like there are many other forums also where you can people of your official, because they enter and right career. So these are the references. My whole presentations are being taken from these three references that I have gone through. Now I'm open for any questions you have. Let me see if there are any questions in chat window. Nothing. Raising hand, don't unmute all. Give me a second.